Hello everyone, I am Kakarla Krishna Kishore, professor in mechanical engineering. Today we are going to discuss solidification of pure metal in material science and technology. So what is pure metal and what is solidification and what is this solidification of pure metals? All these details we are going to discuss in this video. Now let us discuss the solidification of pure metal. Before going to discuss, let me try to give the definition of solidification first. Solidification means, it is also known as freezing, is a phase change of matter that results in the production of a solid. So that means generally this occurs when the temperature of a liquid is lowered below its freezing point. So that means the liquid is going to become a solid at a particular temperature. That is called as solidification. Now, pure metal. What do you mean by pure metals here? Pure metals means are those metals that have not been alloyed with other metallic elements. This is very, very salient feature, that is important salient feature. Commercially, pure metals are 99% pure minimum. We cannot assure that all pure metals are having 100% purity. No, we cannot assure like that. We can assure at least 99% purity. The 1% is the other materials. Now, in that case, so here you have understood the solidification and pure metals. Now, at what temperature it solidifies? So that means at what temperature the pure metal solidifies. Please observe the sentence first. Here it completely depends on the melt and solidify. That means pure metals melt and solidify at a single temperature, which may be termed as melting point or freezing point. Anyway, we are going to observe this particular temperature on the graph, which is represented as a cooling curve. So that means here this sentence clearly says that pure metals will solidify at single temperature. So before going to understand the cooling curve, let me discuss what is cooling curve here. The cooling curve means, if you observe the cooling curve means it is a graphical plot of the changes in temperature with time for a material over the entire temperature range through which it cools. So this is only a definition which clearly says that it is a graphical representation and with temperature. Here the temperature is important, that means temperature versus time. So temperature is on y-axis, time is on x-axis, and at the various temperature how the material behaves, all these things, all this data are going to be noted down in a graphical plot. So let us see the cooling curve for the pure metal. Please observe the cooling curve for pure metal. This is the cooling curve for pure metal. So that means if it is not pure, if the alloys are existed, then the phase, that is this diagram, the cooling curve diagram may have some changes. If you observe the red line here, in initial stage, so that means at initial time, it is the liquid phase here and up to some position. This is the liquid end point. At this point, so this is called as a freezing point. So that means solidification starting point. If you observe this here, for pure metal, this solidification temperature is a horizontal line. If solidification temperature is a horizontal line, it means that the temperature is constant. That means at constant temperature or at the constant freezing temperature, the solidification is happened for pure metal. This is the solidification ending point here. That is, after that, that means almost the total liquid is going to be disappeared after this point. Then all this is a solid state. All this is solid state. So this is for pure metal. If you observe this under equilibrium conditions, here the important parameter is this particular graph may be valid. That is, we can validate this graph if the conditions are equilibrium. All metals, whatever the metals which are in periodic table, all those metals will exhibit a definite melting or freezing point here. So that means here, this pure metal, whatever the pure metal, that is 99% purity, this metal cooling curve will show a horizontal line at the melting point or freezing temperature. So that means this is also represented as a melting point or freezing temperature or freezing point. Now let us observe the various features and various points in cooling curve, that is for pure metal. If you observe here, this is the detailed graph between temperature versus time for pure metal. So this is the pouring temperature, that is at the initial stage at which the hot metal enters into the mold cavity, and after it settled down, so this is called as a pouring temperature. After that, it is in liquid state. Slowly the liquid is going to be cooled. That means this is a liquid cooling. This is the time. It will take some time for cooling. So all this, in all this state, the metal is in the form of liquid, that is hot metal. And at some position, the freezing begins. That means solidification starts, which is also represented as a local solidification time. So that means, what do you mean by local solidification time? Local solidification time means the freezing starting temperature to the time between freezing starting temperature to the time at which the freezing is completed. So that means between these two points, whatever the time is existed, that is called as local solidification time. And total solidification time, here we also considered a total solidification time. Total solidification time means at which after pouring is completed, now the liquid is going to be cooled. If you consider this also as a solidification time, so this is liquid solidification, this is solid solidification. If you add these two, then that is represented as total solidification time. Now after that, as we have seen the last one, that is in the last image, the same picture, but this is a detailed image. This is called as a solid cooling. It will be in the form of a curve. Slowly it will cool slowly, the solid. After that, it will completely converted as a solid form. And here two conditions may be existed. So that means this type of horizontal line, you are observing the cooling curve freezing temperature as a horizontal line. This horizontal line is completely depends on the condition. Now let us see on what condition the horizontal line depends. Now see the first condition here. Already you have seen this image. When is this image going to be formed? So that means when the horizontal line is going to be formed. Please observe the sentence here. If a number of temperature measurements are taken at different times while pure metal is cooled under equilibrium conditions. Here the condition is, if whatever the discussion up to now, that is we have discussed, if it is comes under that, if it is cooled under equilibrium conditions, then we can say that this type of phase diagram, so that means a horizontal line for solidification is going to be formed. And the condition is from molten state till to solidifies, a time temperature plot. So this is also represented as a time temperature plot. So that means graph will look like this. Here the condition is for a horizontal line to be formed is cooled under equilibrium conditions. So let us see the second condition here. Now observe this image. This is also cooling curve for pure metal, but if you observe here, this type of a small curve may be formed for some times instead of cooling curve. So that means only a portion of the horizontal line may be formed like this. When this is going to be formed? Please observe the sentence here. Here, if A pure metal cools rapidly. So this is the main point here. When compared to the previous case, the previous image shows that it forms under or it cools under equilibrium conditions. But here, if it cools rapidly, when it is very easy or when it is very pure and does not contain any impurity as nucleus to start crystallization, it may cool as per the following figure. Here two sentences that we have used. One is nucleus here, and what is this here? This is called as undercooling. Here nucleus, what do you mean by nucleus and when it is going to be formed and what do you mean by undercooling? Let us discuss the undercooling and nucleus. Before going to that, let me clear, this type of undercooling will be happened when the metal cools rapidly. And this undercooling may not be formed if this metal is cooled in equilibrium condition. That is the main difference between before, that is without undercooling and with undercooling. So let us discuss what is undercooling here. Observe the image. Only a small portion on the horizontal line is formed as a crust like this. That means this area is represented as a undercooling. And if a metal is 100% pure and contains no other traces of other elements, then undercooling may occur before solidification begins. This is the solidification point here. Before this solidification begins, this type of undercooling maybe happens if it is 100% pure, but which is not existed in this universe. So that means almost all metals are considered as 99% purity. So that means for all the pure metal, we are going to get this type of curve only. And undercooling is when the temperature drops below the liquid to solid temperature for a short period only. So observe this word here. This only happened for a short period. So that means only for a shorter period of time this undercooling is happened, and again the freezing temperature starts and freezing temperature ends as a straight line. So this is about undercooling. Then what is nucleation in solidification of pure metal? Observe the nucleation here. Observe the microstructure image. In initial stage, that means when metal is going to be cooled, then these type of crystals, all these type of crystals, that is the single crystals, are going to be combined like this. So that means at the solidification temperature, atoms from the liquid, so all these are liquid atoms here, such as molten metal, that is when it is at molten condition, begins to bond together and start to form crystals. This moment, whenever they want to begin to start or bond to start or bond together, then we can say that the moment a crystal begins to grow is known as nucleus. And you can see the nucleus formation here. Slowly all these two combine together and form a single one, and this is called as a nucleus. And the point where it occurs is the nucleation point at which this particular nucleus is observed. This is called as nucleus and nucleus point here. And how they are growing here? You can observe the continuation images here. In the earlier images, they are about to bond here. They have bond completely here. If you can observe the sentence here, when the metal begins to solidify, the multiple crystals, all these are multiple crystals, begins to grow in the liquid. So this, the final size, whatever the final size here, this is the final size, assume this as a final size of the individual crystal depends on the number of nucleation points. Suppose if the number of nucleation points increases, the size of individual crystals will increase. Finally, after formation of the nucleation points or nucleations or individual crystals, this final crystal may be look like this. So that means the grains are going to be formed, and this is called as grain boundary. You can observe clearly. We can observe in another image how they are going to be in direction. You can observe the mold wall here. This is a mold wall or wall of mold here. here equiaxial crystal. So that means in a single direction, all the crystals are going to be formed in a single direction. So these grains are represented as columnar crystals. Columnar crystals. All these are columnar crystals only. All these are going to be formed in a single direction, which is represented as a direction of growth. So we have discussed the various salient features of the solidification of pure metal, and in that what is undercooling, and we have discussed also what is nucleation and when it is going to be formed, and what are the conditions for solidification of pure metals. So this is all about solidification of pure metal. I hope you have understood. In the next coming videos, we will discuss some more points and techniques in material technology. Thank you one and all. I am Kakarla Krishna Kishore signing off.